Hebrews chapter 6, verse 1. Therefore, leaving the principles of the doctrine of Christ, let us go on unto perfection, not laying again the foundation of repentance from our dead works and of faith towards God, of the doctrine of baptisms and of laying on of hands, and of resurrection of the dead and of eternal judgment. And this we will do if God permits. And now the point of these statements from Paul, he is asking them to examine their foundation on the basis of the principles of the doctrine of Christ. And it's also written that there's no other foundation that can be laid than that which is laid. And he's talking about the doctrine of Jesus. And in verse 1, it says, it mentions the principles. He's saying that before we can go beyond the principles of the doctrine of Christ, God's not going to permit that to happen if we don't have the doctrine of Christ as a foundation in our life as a Christian. It's a warning. The rest of that chapter is very serious warnings of how trying to build on a foundation that's not truly the doctrine of Christ can put us on very serious ground, dangerous ground with the Lord, and make us very vulnerable to the enemy. So this is a new perspective, was that Paul would put such an emphasis, an emphatic warning, that they had gotten the principles of the doctrine of Christ so messed up or so wrong that God had to stop them dead in their tracks. And I don't know that there's any Christian that wants to stop God in his tracks in their life. But what is keeping the church from moving out in fullness? I believe it's this right here. And when we go into Jesus' messages to some of the churches, which will be included in this, we can see that there were doctrines that he said he hated and that he commanded that they repent and keep themselves from it and to get it out of their midst. First, let's look at the foundation. So Paul is making the point, you have no cornerstone with which God will allow you to build any further or go any further than you've gone. And he says, those of you who are unskillful in the word, you're still a spiritual baby, and you need strong meat so that you can discern good and evil. See, these are for our own protection that the Lord gives us these warnings. That's what the word of God is for. It's our teacher. Holy Spirit is our teacher and our discerner. The wise man built his house up on the rock, and it withstood everything that came against it. And this is the focus of the Lord Jesus Christ today to the body of Christ. Go back and look at your foundation, church, and see where you have it wrong and correct it and repent. And then you shall be restored to me, and I will consider whether or not to lead you out in fullness in this hour. And all, we should be willing to do any and everything to please the Lord Jesus. For the church, this is our generation, church. This is our generation. So we see that it is the foundation of repentance from dead works and of faith towards God. So repentance and faith is seated right there. It's poured into our very foundation. Next is the doctrine of baptisms. And it's important that we see that that's plural. The doctrine of baptisms. This is elemental. It's a principle of the doctrine of Christ. There's the water baptism. And then there's the baptism of the Holy Spirit. Three is the laying on of hands. I think that represents the propagation of the power of the gospel to one another, and as we go out and preach the gospel to others. And number 5 is the resurrection of the dead. And number 6 is of eternal judgment. So Paul has set out for us 6 things that should be in the principles of the doctrine of Christ and our foundation, that are absolutely required before God will bring any maturity or growth. And he is the vine, we are the branches, and his Father is the husbandman. That means the overseer of the vineyard. He will do the pruning and cutting and determination of how we're going to grow. What he will allow to, continue, what he will perpetuate, or what he will stop and cut back and hold back. So I believe what the Lord wants us to do is let's examine those 6 points of doctrine. And what could be more important to us than what's important in the eyes of the Father as the husbandman? Is that we need to have this fruit on our branches. We need to have these leaves in glowing abundance upon us, so that when he examines us, he's going to allow us to go further.